For a year or two, we were just played alone with no third guitar. Cassie kept talking about her little brother. Oh, he's a great guitar player. But everybody used to tell us, oh man, you should hear this guy, or my cousin, you'd love him, he's great. We're gone. Okay. So finally we were playing in a town where he had a band called Crawdaddy. So he came to our show that night and he brought his guitar because he was going to a gig. We said, why don't you come play on Mr. Breeze with us? And he was great. He played the shit out of it.
He was so tremendous. I just told Ronnie and Gary that night, you know, like, hey, he's the one. Steve Gaines is going to fit right there.
The first week or two, all we did do all day and night was show him stuff and work him into all the songs so he could go play the live album. In a couple of weeks.
Fire from the live theater, Lynyrd Skynyrd!
Oh, I'm going to tell you about this gentleman that's playing with us tonight. It's a big member of Lynyrd Skynyrd's name, Steve Gaines, over here. He's from Oklahoma. He's old Okie. Looks out of the South Oklahoma.
Well, this might sound egotistical, but I think right now I have a guitar player with me named Steve Gaines, who is probably the most underestimated guitar player on the south side of the Mason-Dixon line.
Steve had all these songs that he'd already written, he brought in, and then we would skinnerize and make one of his songs ours. Me and Alan were offering probably as much as we could have at the time. We were so burnt, we kind of got uninspired. We knew something was missing. And Steve was it. It was like he found us, brought a spark back to everything. He made us get serious again, and we would rehearse more and work up guitar parts more.
Steve could grow excellent, like, tomatoes. I wouldn't call him a farm boy, but he could grow some bud.
When I get on stage and Skynyrd's crowds are there, it just means everything to me. That's all I've wanted to do up till now, and now I'm trying to figure out what I can do from here, you know.
Very exuberant.
Lynyrd Skynyrd was strengthened even further by the introduction of a new guitarist in May 1976, a position that Van Zant had been considering filling ever since Ed King's departure. Upon her arrival in the band, backing vocalist Cassie Gaines had been recommending her younger brother, Steve. Yet this suggestion was initially dismissed by the band as they were looking for a higher profile player. In May, however, at a show in Kansas City, Van Zant invited Steve Gaines to audition with Skynyrd at a live concert, and following further jams with the band, he proved that he was more than qualified to take on the role of third guitarist.
He got out and played with us in front of about 80,000 people. Ronnie asking that day, you know, be a part of the band.
At the time Ed left the band, there was everybody in the band had tremendous drug and alcohol problems. And so I'm not blaming anybody. It wasn't Ed's fault. It wasn't Ronnie's fault. It was just the times. And Steve came at a great time. Steve's very mellow, laid-back intellect came in. That in itself helped us right the ship. We were a happy family, and everybody wanted to be cool for Steve, you know, because he was such a nice guy. You know, the band didn't want Steve to know that they were out of their mind, drunken maniacs, you know. That was later. That came later.
Reinvigorated by the introduction of this young virtuoso, in July the band recorded a live album across 3 dates at Atlanta's Fox Theater. After the rushed Nothing Fancy and the commercial disappointment of Give Me Back My Bullets, Skynyrd needed to re-establish their energy on record, and with One More From the Road, released in September 1976, they succeeded. Peaking in the top 10 in the US and going platinum before the year was out, it restored their reputation.
I remember when it came out, you know, it sounded phenomenal. Skynyrd was a live band. You know, they lived to play live. I mean, you could tell. That's their thing, you know. They're musicians, you know. I mean, they're going to thrive on an audience and ratcheting things up to another level. So, you know, Freebird Live is just phenomenal, you know. It's everything it should be.
Lynyrd Skynyrd recorded One More From the Road in July 1976. Steve Gaines had only been a member of the band for 2 months. As strong as the album is,
as much as it was a great live album that really reestablished them and stands the test of time, I believe if it had been recorded 2 or 3 months later, it would have been quite a bit better. Steve Gaines was a fantastic guitar player who had unique ideas, jump-started the band, and surely gave a kick in the behind to Gary Rossington and Alan Collins, because as a musician, if you add another person of that caliber into the mix, it has to do that. It just has to. It has to change the dynamics. And I think what you hear on this live album is the very beginnings of that happening.
This confirmation of the band's status as one of the greatest live acts in the world continued in 1976 with a show in front of their biggest crowd to date. On August the 21st, almost 2 months after the Fox Theatre concerts were recorded, Skynyrd travelled to the UK to perform at the Knebworth Festival, on a bill headlined by the band who had initially inspired Ronnie Van Zant to pursue music in the first place, the Rolling Stones.
We're on stage in front of 500,000 people, and Steve Gaines has taken a solo. And you can see Ronnie back up to him on this humongous stage. And you can see a smile. And you can see that he's thinking to himself, man, am I a smart guy, man, for bringing this Steve Gaines dude into the band. You know, because Steve's just shredding on this solo. And Ronnie's got this beautiful smile on his face. See that moment that he just looks at Steve, and to me that says it all. Steve Gaines made a huge difference in the band.